Every year in the house, there's a phrase that's never far from the lips of those suspicious housemates. That phrase is game plan. Here to talk us through the psychology of game plans and mind games is Dr. Tomáš Chmura Premusik. How you doing, sir?
I'm all right, how are you?
Lovely to have you back on the show. So, we're talking game plans with you. Is it possible to execute a really cleverly played game plan in the house?
Well, really cleverly played is quite ambitious, but I'd say it's almost impossible not to have a game plan.
Okay.
Even deciding not to have a game plan is a game plan.
Right, okay.
But in reality, most game plans really involve the same, they're quite simple and they involve the same elements over and over again.
We've got some of the key elements here, if you talk us through them.
Yeah, the first one is, well, you have to choose your friends and enemies very carefully. It sounds like The Godfather, I know, but you really have to try to get close to people who are popular and try to avoid friendships with people who are unpopular, which means really adjusting who you hang out with over and over again.
So by association you can either be, you know, popular or unpopular.
Exactly. And I think after every eviction we can see how the same housemates who nominated some people then realize if they're safe that they're quite popular, and then they stop.
Because Bex all of a sudden seems very, very popular.
Exactly. One day she was unpopular, and the other day, you know, nobody really wants to have fights with her. The second element is staying sufficiently off the radar. And this is important to keep your game plan secret, but also because you avoid upsetting other housemates by stealing the limelight from them. So also the viewers, if they always see the same housemates monopolizing attention, they get bored of that.
Right, okay.
So you have to stay quiet.
But then you've got people like Rachel who stays quiet, and now she's getting grief for staying quiet.
I think it's because other housemates think that she's only staying quiet because it is a game plan, when in fact she might be a little bit... Well, she was extroverted in the beginning, but I think she's now overwhelmed with other things happening there.
Okay.
The third important issue is make others do your job. And this is where most housemates really fail in their game plan.
Luke's particularly good at this, right?
He's excellent at that. Basically, if you dislike somebody, don't confront that person. Yeah. Don't have fights. Send others. Make that person unpopular to others so that you gather nominations for that person. And also, in case the viewers find that person quite popular, you are not at risk.
Right, okay. So quite a conniving little element.
I think, yes, it is. And the third one, I said, is where most housemates fail if the game plans are not, you know, cleverly designed.
Okay, and now one kind of housemate who's got a fairly, it doesn't seem that sophisticated to me, is Sarah. She's coming, new housemate, immediately just throwing herself at all the boys.
Absolutely, I agree. Not very sophisticated, but I think a blatant example of a game plan.
Okay, let's have a little look at Sarah now.
Hey, Rexy, I've got leopard print undies on. Can you see?
I wish I had dimples, Stu.
Please.
You wish you had dimples?
Yeah, I love dimples.
How does it do that like that?
Slow? Like Moe's.
I know.
So cute. I love dimples. They turn me on.
Give me all your
hands. Oh! Oh my God! It's happening!
Surely, if she kisses all the boys, some of them are going to start getting upset at some point.
Well, even Kat as well, she kissed.
Right, and the girls also, yes.
Yeah, I think she's probably been watching the show before she entered the house. She knew there was a vacant place there. Jen's post, she was a flirt before Sarah got
in. Alpha female, basically.
Yeah, or at least the predominant flirt. So, obviously, she's not just trying to flirt with the boys, but avoid them nominating her. It's a dangerous
risky
game.
Risky
business. First of all, because there's already a history of good-looking female housemates exiting the house quite soon. And secondly, because she can upset the people that she's not flirting. And she might prove too much for housemates and the audience. And it's also not very subtle.
Do we like Sarah?
Yeah.
Well, seems to be working so far.
Yeah, I think it's a short-term game plan.
Okay. And Luke, obviously, master of the game plan, but also very shrewd punter. He seems to see what everybody else is doing as well, right?
Yeah, I think he's definitely the psychologist in the house. In fact, I'm a bit worried that he leaves and steals my
job. Takes your
job,
right, next season. Yeah, and then he'll have the whole angle there, celebrity, fancy. Yeah, well, sorry about that.
Yeah, but definitely very sophisticated, both playing the games and working out what other people are doing.
Okay, we've got a little clip of him doing just that.
I believe my fans, if I have any, would vote to evict Mario, to be honest.
Yeah.
Just to keep Rebecca and I together.
It's tactical voting that's going on here, Rebecca. People are being voted out because they're a threat to the £100,000 cheque at the end of it. This host walked for you at one of you two at this fire in the world tomorrow because you two are threat to the £100,000 cheque. There's people out there in this house, or that she will screw every single one of us over now. She'll stand on us all to get this cheque, we know that.
It's not Rachel.
Yeah?
Okay, so we'll boo one, a solitary boo.
I think it's, although people might not like it, you know, it's admirable that he has this capacity of insight and know, you know, to decipher what's going on. He's given Rebecca a lecture of what's going on. In a sense, one may argue, it's not just that he needs to verbalize these things, but it might be his game plan, just discuss other people's game plan to, you know, hide his own.
Right, okay, wow, he might even be cleverer than we think.
I think he's very clever, there's no doubt about that.
Right, okay. And then obviously I'm wondering, you know, are they all premeditated game plans? Can they just evolve, or do you have to go in there with a real clear, you know, view of what it is you want to do?
I think if housemates enter the house, like Sarah, with a specific game plan in mind, they're bound to fail.
Yeah.
So they have to be organic, dynamic, develop, you have to get feedback from others. But they're always conscious. By definition, it's a conscious strategy that you have to have to eliminate your enemies.
Okay, and of course, one of the other phrases that keeps coming up is mind games. What's the difference between a game plan and mind games?
They're related in that the mind games are the raw materials, if you want, that make up the game plans, okay. But there are much more natural day-to-day psychological processes that housemates and people in general need to adopt to work out what's going on and to influence other people.
Okay, we've got some mind games here for you now.
I don't get that girl, mate.
So just a bit all over the top, isn't
it? I'll admit, like, of all the things I've ever
like,
complained
I didn't get
about
the stuff yesterday about,
yeah.
Oh, Darnell, you say that so funny. Oh, you do say
yeah.
Baby. Say it
yeah.
Again, say
yeah.
It again. Oh,
yeah.
That's amazing, that is so amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, the way you do yeah. That thing where you scratch your head.
No, just the same, just the
I don't think that's part of being breed, I think that's just hurt.
Okay, so what's going on? They're trying to have a go at Sarah there, or...?
It's two things at the same time. First of all, they're trying to work out Sarah, who is a new housemate. But secondly, they're trying to emphasize the barrier between being an old group and the new housemate. So they're actually consolidating that group, and they're negotiating whether the groups like Sarah or not. In a sense, what Lux does on his own, you know, telling us what is made up, compensated collectively, perhaps because Dale and Stuart don't have Luke's capacity to decide what's going on or to influence the viewers.
Right, okay. So do you think there is some kind of, you know, influencing of the viewers going on there then? Do you think they are trying to make us think, you know, a certain way about, you know, people who are coming into the house?
I think there always is. They're probably more concerned about influencing each other housemates, but obviously that has an impact on the viewers because if you're a fan of, you know, ex-housemate and that housemate said he doesn't like another housemate, then you're going to agree with that or not. So
right.
It's rallying, you know, and negotiating whether people move from one house against one housemate or in favor of other.
Dr. Thomas, wonderful insight as ever. Fascinating. Thank you very much.